made arrangements during the last lecture. Very many of you ran away. We are so happy that and I'm also happy that you are not here. So we want to look at how to manage our information. That is information management. We know that it is so important, as we read in chapter 3, concerning information and the sources of information for business. So we now want to look at the information management. Normally what will come to our mind is the record management system. We have a lot of records that are kept in various departments. For example, in marketing, we have the sales record, we have the accounting records in the accounting department. We have all these records that will help us to get or develop information or store information that may be useful to us in taking management decisions. Okay, these are the flimsy records, like circular that is passed. The copy of that circular is kept. Action that's supposed to be taken on that circular is considered. And once it is taken, then you consider that that particular action has been taken. And you have executed now to discard with such information over a passage of time. That's why we now listed those ones as non-essential records. Form letters, circulars, notices of people.